Hi everyone, welcome to Naresha Technologies. This is Srinivas. In this video, we are going to discuss about a tuple collection type in Python. In a previous videos, we have discussed already list completely. And this is another collection type. It will store the elements. Here, what are the differences between list and tuple? So what is a tuple? So how can we allocate the memory to tuple? How elements will store, what type of elements will store, and all we will discuss in this video. We are opening that IDLE. So first of all, how to create a tuple? We are representing the tuple with a parenthesis. List we are representing with a square brackets. Here it is a tuple. For example, t equal to, we are representing with parenthesis. We are storing the elements 10, 20, 30, 40, suppose. We are printing directly, we are printing, I am not using any iterators like loops and all. See in which order we are storing the elements, in the same order we are getting. Tuple is an ordered collection, in which order we are inserting the elements, in the same order the elements will be processed. Here it is into the tuple, can we store duplicate elements or not? And can we store heterogeneous elements or not? Yes, we can. We can store duplicates. We can store heterogeneous elements also. So, here it is. Tuple allows duplicates and heterogeneous elements. Different types of elements we can store. And here it is, can we use indexing and slicing means what? Yes, just like list, we can process elements through indexing, and slicing. We know, through indexing, we can access element by element. Multiple elements, if you want to access, we use a slicing concept. Here, whenever we are storing, we are creating one tuple, just the with the values. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, first through indexing, and of course negative indexing also it supports. For example, t of 1, the value 20. For example, t of minus 2, here it is the value is a 40, and here it is a t of. For example, slicing concept we are using. I am not giving that lower bound and upper bound, so it will display all. So everything will be displayed. So indexing and slicing also supports. It's an ordered collection. It is allowed to store duplicates and heterogeneous elements. Now, the question is, sir, then what is the difference between list and tuple is the question. So only one simple difference here, list is mutable. It's nothing but it's not constant, whereas tuple is immutable. It's constant, nothing but we cannot modify after creation. Once the tuple is ready, you cannot modify. That's the reason in list is providing many predefined functions, a predefined object functionality, or simply predefined functions to modify the list. It's like a add function, and next one suppose insert function, remove function, pop function, right, a reverse function, so many functions it has provided. So what all these functions are doing means what? It is modifying the list. But tuple is not providing all these functions. Modification functions not present in tuple. So whenever we are creating one tuple with some duplicates also, we are writing just to understand 10, 20, 10, 30, 10, like this. Here it is whenever we are checking like a t dot, it will show that list. How many functions are present in the tuple? Only two, just count and index. Here it is a count function. Will return the duplicate count of a specified element. For example, if I specify 10, the count is a 3. 3 times it is present. and here it is a t dot, one more function is a index. Whenever you specify 30, where it is present, at third location it is present. Suppose here it is a t dot index, if I give 10, the first occurrence only will return. It is present at 0th location. Only two functions are present in a tuple. One is a count function, next one is a index function. These two functions present in a list also. These two functions will not modify the object, just providing the information of object elements. All remaining functions of a list will try to modify that list. Here it is, we cannot modify the tuple because tuple is immutable object. So whenever tuple is immutable object, you cannot modify. That's a rule. Immutable means constant. So that's why constant functionality they have to provide. Yes, they have provided. That's the reason all the modification functions they removed from the tuple. Only two functions are present in the tuple. Only two, just count and index. So almost all the functions are common for list and tuple. The only difference, the simple difference is what? List is a mutable object, it's not constant. Tuple is immutable object, it's constant object. Okay, so hope you understood. In the next video, I'll explain what type of elements we can store in the tuple. Thank you.